What is up, weather enthusiasts? I'm your host, Pat's Path Predictor. Let's get right into the weather. All right, so here's the situation we have for you, ladies and gentlemen. We have a big situation that's going on. We have Hurricane Tammy continuing to meander in the Atlantic Ocean, and we have Invest 95L getting closer and closer to Nicaragua, continuing to show more and more signs of organization before it makes landfall. Definitely stuff we need to pay attention to as time continues to go on. Here's the quick update we have for you guys over here. If you go ahead and start with the Eastern Pacific, we're going to start with Tropical Storm Otis real quickly, as this is expected to be making landfall as a tropical storm in Mexico. Not really that much breaking news on this. We've seen a lot of these happen in October so far. We had Norma recently make landfall as well. But anyway, here's the public advisory. Maximum sustained winds are at 45 miles per hour. Present movement is north-northwest at 340 degrees or at 7 miles per hour. Pressure is 1,002 millibars, so a bit low for a 45 mile per hour tropical storm over here. Tropical storm force winds also extend outward 70 miles from the center, so definitely stuff we need to pay attention to as time continues to go on. So that's the situation. Here's the discussion. As right here, it's expected to strengthen to a 65 mile per hour tropical storm before making landfall in Mexico and then dissipating as time continues to go on. Otis has been relatively steady in strength this morning. Satellite images indicate that deep convection has been pulsing during this past several hours. The low-level center remains on the east side of the thunderstorm activity due to easterly wind shear. The satellite intensity estimates have not changed much. The intensity is held at 40 knots or 45 miles per hour at this current time. However, it is expected, once again, to get up to strong tropical storm strength, and some models actually have this as a weak hurricane before making landfall. We'll have to see how this whole thing plays out, but that's what we have with Otis. Next thing we're showing you briefly is Tammy, 80-mile-per-hour hurricane. The current pressure is 993 millibars. Its current location is 21.9 degrees north, 63.9 degrees west, and it's moving north at 7 miles per hour. It's expected to start turning to the east and then start turning to the west afterward, as we can show you right here. It's expected to become extratropical by Thursday and then start moving towards Bermuda and approach there by Saturday. So this is definitely something we need to pay attention to, especially for our Bermudian viewers who are tuning in right now. Here's the situation that we have. Hurricane force winds still extend outward 25 miles from the center, and tropical storm force winds extend outward 125 miles from the center. So this system is rather average size, to be honest, for a Category 1 hurricane at this current point. So we'll have to pay attention to it as time continues to progress. It's about 260 miles north of Anguilla. At this current point in time, it's moving north, pretty much almost due north at this current point in time as well. Here's the discussion we have for you as well. And this is what we're looking at. Maybe gets up to 90 miles per hour in the next 36 hours before starting a weakening trend and eventually becomes post-tropical or extratropical as it starts to approach Bermuda and weaken due to stronger and stronger wind shear starting to affect it down the road. So that's the situation we have with the intensity forecast. Here's what we have. Tammy appears to be holding steady in spite of moderately southerly vertical wind shear. There have been regular bursts of convection over the center and a fragmented band around the eastern portion of the circulation. The latest intensity is held at 70 knots to represent a blend of the subject satellite intensity, which are 77 knots and 65 knots, respectively. For those of you who do not know, 77 knots is around... It's around 90 miles per hour, and 65 knots is 75 miles per hour, just for those of you who are tuning in from the United States at this current point. So that's what we have with Tammy over here. Last thing we're checking out is Invest 95L, continuing to show signs of organization and development, as it says with the guidelines right here, according to the NHC. Here's the situation we have right here. Showers and thunderstorms, like I said before, continue to show signs of organization and association with a low pressure system located over the southwestern Caribbean Sea. Environmental conditions appear to be favorable for development, and a short-lived tropical depression could form before the system moves inland over Nicaragua by early Tuesday. Regardless of development, this system could produce heavy rains over portions of Central America during the next couple of days. Chances of formation are still at 60%, so this thing still has a good chance of organization and development at this current time, ladies and gentlemen. So this is definitely something we need to pay attention to at this current time. But with that being said, as we continue to get into this more active weather period, be sure to check out my friends over at Prestige Weather Consulting. They do individual one-on-one weather consulting catered to your local area. For more information on them, be sure to check them out in the link in the description down below. And be sure to use the code PREDICTOR for 50% off your first month, ladies and gentlemen. I highly recommend you try out their services. They've been helping me out quite a bit with the channel, so thank you very much, guys. With that being said, here's the situation we have with the European. We're going to run the operational models and then get to the hurricane models and maybe talk about the conditions along the way and then some other stuff that's going to be coming up soon. So here's what we have with the European. European showing Tammy just kind of remaining a Category 1 hurricane while staying out to sea. Meanwhile, with 95L and Otis over here, with Otis, the European is forecasting this to strengthen potentially up to a strong tropical storm, 999 millibar system, right before it makes landfall in the area over there. It's already 1,002 as of right now, as a 45-mile-per-hour tropical storm, so we'll have to see how this whole thing plays out. But in the meantime, as for 95L, we're looking at a pressure of around 1,007 millibars as it's starting to approach the Nicaraguan coast and bring a lot of rain and a lot of potentially some wind across Nicaragua, Honduras, Panama, and maybe even Costa Rica as well. So that's something we need to pay attention to as time continues to progress with the European model. And now we'll go ahead and show you the GFS model. The GFS has been pretty interesting, to say at the very least. The GFS is potentially having this thing strengthen 95L, rather strengthen into a tropical storm before making landfall in Nicaragua. That would be Tropical Storm Vince if that were to happen at that current point. And then as for Otis, it's showing signs of organization and then potentially making landfall around somewhere around Mexico. The GFS model there is a little bit wonky with that, so we'll have to keep an eye on it. However, I wouldn't rely on the GFS model, at least in the Eastern Pacific at this current point in time. In the meantime, as for Tammy, similar situation to the European, just kind of stays out to sea and then makes a hard turn to the west before potentially impacting Bermuda and then heading more out to the east and then kind of making some loop-de-loops and then kind of eventually dying down as time continues to go on. The GFS is known for its very wonky tracks, so I would take this with a massive grain of salt if I were you. So that's what we have with the GFS. Next thing we're showing you is the CMC model. CMC has been pretty interesting, and it's been one of the more consistent models, to say at the very least. The CMC has Otis making landfall as a strong tropical storm, and in the meantime, it has 95L doing its own thing over here, if we can go ahead and pull that up. It's having it approach Nicaragua as a tropical system, and then bring lots of heavy rainfall and maybe some winds before entering the eastern Pacific, and then maybe making landfall in El Salvador, maybe Guatemala, before eventually dissipating as time continues to go on. And as for Otis, the situation with Otis is expected, according to the CMC, to strengthen potentially to a Category 1 hurricane before making landfall in Mexico as a tropical storm as wind shear starts to tear it apart. So we'll have to see how that whole thing plays out as time continues to progress. Next thing we're showing you is the NavGem model. NavGem's been pretty interesting throughout this whole thing, to say at the very least. The NavGem is showing 95L approaching as a tropical depression or maybe a weak tropical storm and then making landfall in Nicaragua while bringing lots of heavy rain to Honduras, El Salvador, Nicaragua, Costa Rica, those areas as time continues to progress. As for Otis, the NavGem is actually having this thing strengthen to a strong tropical storm around 65 miles per hour before making landfall In southern Mexico, similar to what the NHC has been calling for. As for Tammy, just remains out to sea and doesn't really do that much in retrospect. So that's what we have going on with the Nav Gem. Last model we're going to show you is the Icon model. Icon's been pretty interesting, to say at the very least. Icon is having 95L. It's not having it really develop as much as the other models are. But as for Otis, it's expected to strengthen into a strong tropical storm. Same old with that. And then with... Tammy, the Icon's actually having this weaker than it is right now, which is pretty interesting to say at the very least, because the pressure's 993 and the winds are at 80 miles per hour. I'm not sure what the Icon is exactly missing at that current at this time right now, but it's definitely something that I am paying attention to as time continues to progress. Now we got to show you the conditions. Global sea temperatures, 30 plus degrees Celsius, where Indefest 95L is at this current point. Tammy's starting to enter cooler and cooler waters, so I do expect it to weaken after it gets past the 26 degree point. And as for Otis, it's going to be moving through warmer and warmer waters as it approaches the Gulf of Mexico. So it's not the Gulf of Mexico, but southern Mexico, as it's expected to potentially organized and strengthened, but there is some wind shear that is hindering it at this current point. Actually, with Otis, there's not very much wind shear that's going to be impacting it, so the only thing that's really going to be stopping it is if the storm gets in its own way. The same can't be said for Tammy, though, because there is increasing wind shear starting to impact it more and more. 95L, very little wind shear at this current point. The only thing that's really playing against it right now is time, and depending on how that whole thing plays out, and depending on how quickly this organizes, this still has like a good 12 to 15 hours before making landfall in Nicaragua. So at this current point, it's basically now or never. So if 95L wants to develop, it needs to do it in the next like 6 hours, or else it won't happen. And then with the ocean heat content over here, the OHC has been pretty interesting, to say at the very least. Where Tammy is, the OHC is around 100 to 125 OHC. Where 95L is, it's around 100 OHC, so there's more than enough fuel to really start this thing and really get this thing going as time continues to go on with this system. So that's definitely something that we'll have to pay attention to as time continues to progress. And before we end this video, I wanted to make a couple of announcements. The first announcement is it's going to be released at the same time as this video is. There's going to be a poll out whether I should be covering some other tropical systems out in the Western Pacific, like other regions of the world. If you guys would like some coverage on that, and would you guys watch that? I'd like you to please go ahead and vote for that. It should be in the community tab, so I recommend you check that out. Second announcement I'm going to be making is hurricane season's dying down at this current point, so we're going to be switching up the content maybe in a little bit. We're going to be working on some documentaries to keep you guys entertained and to keep you guys engaged with weather. So that's what we're working on right here on the Pat's Path Predictor channel. Just wanted to give you guys those announcements so that way you know what's coming up. But with that being said, we're going to go ahead and close the video out right here. I hope you enjoyed it. Be sure to leave a like and subscribe to the channel if you are new. It helps us out, helps us make more videos like these. The goal of this channel is to get more people engaged with weather. Be sure to check out my friends over at Prestige Weather Consulting. Be sure to use the code Predictor for 50% off your first month. And with that being said, have a wonderful day, guys. Stay safe.